Okay, so welcome to Data Studies Mastery session. So in this video, we'll be discussing about how to use index function and field function in transformer stage. Okay, so those who are watching my channel for the first time, please subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon so that whenever I uploaded a video, you will get a notification. Thank you. So this is my source input data. So here I have four records. Okay, my expected target file, target data should be like this. So I have PhD code and followed by PhD number. So my input has PhD details. It has PhD combination of PhD code and a PhD number. And if the PhD code is not found, okay, so first year there will be hyphen value. So when there is no hyphen value, so you need to pass the 000. Okay, so how to handle this scenario? So this was the common interview questions, so most of the students are asking me. So just I want to make an video so that this video can help for you. You can share the same thing in the interview panel. Okay, they ask the same scenario. So how to apply the logic? So this is the required, input data they given, and this is the expected output. Okay, expected target file. So let's move on to data studies job. So here is the job that I have designed. So let's check the source data first. Let's view the source data. Okay, so here I have read that entire data as a file. Okay, so PhD details followed by this three records, total four records are there. So in my output, I need three records and with PhD code and a PhD number. Okay, and PhD details should not be reflected in the output, so that what I did for PhD details should not be reflected in the transformer. The constant I have used the substring whenever it starts with P. So that value have not passed, not equal to substring of one comma, not equal to. So click on OK. So here is the logic that I have built for PhD code and PhD number. Okay. So this is the logic. So let me copy paste in text. Any text pad. So this is the logic. So the index field will helps us the positioning value. Suppose if you want to find any index value, any index of a given pattern that gives the position. Okay. So it will use the number. So here the records having this particular hyphen, so that index position should be zero, should not be zero. Okay, so wherever this in hyphen is there, so it will be having some position. Like if you see the input data, so here you can see fourth position, fifth position. So that should not be equal to zero. So our criteria, that should not be equal to zero. So that is not equal to zero. If it is not equal to zero, I have passed this field function. So field function, which helps us whatever the delimiter that you want to search in a data, and it will be picked up the first position. Okay. So suppose field function of its work, suppose jc@rodav360.com. So if it is like this, so field of the string, data, comma, so @ I give @ symbol. So here first portion is Jesse, and the second portion is after delimiter. Okay, So before delimiter, after delimiter. Before delimiter is that is one position, and after one that is 360.com. Radax 360.com. So this is the way the field function works. So here we need only whenever the index value is not null, it has some hyphen. So we need to pick the first position. So that is the PhD code. Logic for PhD code. PhD. Okay. And if it is zero. If the index is zero, if it is not there, means it will be zero, right? So if it is zero, pass the 333000. Okay, pass 333. Sorry, pass 000. Okay, so here you can see. So for this record, we don't have iPhone, right? So for that purpose, I have given three zeros. Okay, so this is for logic for PhD code. What is the logic for PhD number? Let's see. So logic for PhD number. Now we need to pick the second position, right? So whenever it has same, whenever the indexes, the index found, in the index function found the value not equal to zero. So then we are populating the second field. That is a PhD number. Okay. So if index is zero, then we are populating the data as it is. Okay. So these two logics I will give you in the description. Okay. So for a PhD number and a PhD code. PhD code and PhD number. These two logics I will give you in the description. So you can validate and by taking this sample data, you can train your data strategy. Environment. Okay, so now click on OK. So in my output, I required as a tab delimiter file. Okay, so you can see here we have a record to record tab space. Okay, tab space. So click on OK. Click on OK, and double click on target. So mention the file location, and first line as a header, and delimiter we can pass it as a tab so that we will get the gap between two columns. Now click on OK. Now save, compile, and run this job. Run the job now. Let's see the data. Okay. So here is the data. It's the same thing you can check in the output. Okay, so we're able to get the relevant output. Thank you. Thanks for watching. And if you are looking for any data science training, any on-job support, off-job support, offline support, offline job support, you can always reach out to me in what my WhatsApp number. Okay, thank you.